Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In today's session, let's look into one of the important programs in Python, that is palindrome. So what is palindrome? Palindrome, we can find the palindrome of a number, or we can find whether the string is palindrome, or we can find whether the number is palindrome. So what does palindrome mean? Suppose my string is having Malayalam as its value, then the reversal of the string also comes as Malayalam. So when the string and the reversal of the string, that is this M comes over here, A L A Y A L A M. So the string and its reversal, reverse order string, both turn out to be the same, then we say that the string is palindrome. And when do we say a number is palindrome? Suppose my number is equal to 12321. Then its reversal, reversal of the number is 12321. So both turn out to be the same. Then we say that the number is also palindrome. If the number and reversal of the number are same, then we say the number is palindrome. So now for this, let's look into the code example and see how we can achieve this. So the code example, coding part of how to find whether the string is palindrome and the number is palindrome. First, let us take the number concept, how to find that the number is palindrome. So for this, firstly, let us take a number num equal to int input, enter a number. So it takes the data from the input from the user. We give this text enter a number, and user enters the input, that is the number, which is type converted into integer, and it is stored in num. And now first let us take one temporary variable and store num in it. The value which user enters will be stored in num, and that num will be stored in a temporary variable. Next, let us make our reverse equal to 0. Initialize reverse equal to 0. Then let me give a while loop. While num greater than 0, so while number is greater than 0, I'm performing some steps, I'm doing some looping. So the first one is digit equal to num percentage 10, reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. Num equal to num float division 10. Let me explain to you this part. And now it comes out of the for loop. Then I say if reverse equal to 10, print palindrome. Else, print not palindrome. So this is the code for checking if a number entered by the user is palindrome or not. So firstly, let me say num equal to int input enter a number. So on the screen, user gets a message enter a number, and user enters the number 1, 2, 3. Suppose user enters the number 1, 2, 3. Then what happens? Num will have the value equal to 1, 2, 3. And temp will also have the value equal to 1, 2, 3. Reverse is 0. and then it enters the while loop and checks if number is greater than 0. Yes, number is greater than 0. So it comes into the while loop and performs these statements. Digit equal to num modulo 10, that is percentage, that is the remainder. So 1, 2, 3 is the number. When you divide it by 10, what is the remainder? The last digit will be the remainder. So digit will now hold the value equal to 3. Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. You have to find the reversal of a number. So every time you multiply it with 10, so that when the loop ends, 3 will be at the first position. So 3 will be at the 100th position. So reverse, as of now reverse is 0. So 0 into 10 is 0 plus digit. Digit is 3. So our reverse will be equal to 3. Now num equal to num floor division 10. It will take only the integer part. Number is equal to 1, 2, 3. When you divide it by 10, our number will now hold the value 1 and 2. Because 120, 10 into 12 is 120. So the quotient is 120. This is the quotient. Digit is the remainder. So number will have the value equal to 12. So it has completed one round where our digit is equal to 3, reverse is equal to 3 and number equal to 12. So this is in the first loop. This comes under the first loop. Now it again checks if number greater than 0. Our number is 12, which is greater than 0. So it enters the loop once again. Digit equal to num modulo 10. Number is 12. So my digit now becomes equal to 2. That is the last digit. When you divide 12 by 10, when you divide 12 by 10, you get the remainder as 2. Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. So my reverse previously was 3. So reverse now becomes equal to 3 into 10 plus 2 plus digit. So 3 into 10 plus digit, which becomes equal to 32. So we have seen our 3 moving to the 10th position. In the third loop, it moves to the 100th position and we get the reversal of the number. So reverse is equal to so much. Num equal to num floor division 10. My num previously was 12. When I divide it by 10, quotient will be 1. So this is the remainder and this is the quotient. So in my second loop, digit is 2. Reverse is 32 and num is 1. So this is the second loop. Second loop. So now again my num is greater than 0. It is greater than 0. So it enters the loop once again. Now digit equal to num per remainder 2. Remainder 10. So digit equal to number is 1. 1 modulo 10. So the remainder is equal to 1. When you divide 1 by 10, that is 10 zeros are 0. So remainder becomes 1. Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. My reverse is equal to 32 into 10 plus digit. What is the digit? Digit is 1. So my reverse now becomes 321. And num will be the quotient. It will be equal to 0 because 10 zeros are 0 because it is 1. So when you do 10 into 0 is 0, you get the remainder 1. So quotient becomes equal to 0. So this is the third loop. This is the third loop, wherein my num has become equal to 0. Now it checks, the while condition checks at number greater than 0. Number is equal to 0. It is not greater than 0. So it comes out of the while loop and it checks if reverse equal to 10. So what is my reverse having? It is 321. that is reversal of 123. Are they equal? Reverse is 321 and temp is 123. They both are not equal, so it prints not palindrome. So this is how we check if a number is palindrome or not. These three statements are very important in checking whether the number is palindrome or not. It will firstly take a digit, last digit, and it will reverse into 10 plus digit. So whatever reverse is there, it will multiply it with 10 and add the digit. In the first case, digit was 3, reverse was 3. Because reverse initially was 0, 0 into 10 becomes 0 plus digit. So reverse and digit were same. In the second one, reverse into 10. So 3 into 10 plus digit. Digit is 2. So it became 32. So in every iteration, our units place shifts to by 10. It gets multiplied by 10. Firstly, 3 was at units place. Then it came to tens place. Then it came to hundreds place. And our tens place, it remains at the tens place. And the one hundreds place goes to the unit place. So it's the reversal of a number. So after getting the reversal, we check for the temp value. Temp is having the number entered by the user. So we check if reverse equal to temp. If both are same, it will print palindrome. Else, it will print not palindrome. So in this scenario, it prints not palindrome because they both are different. The reversal and the number both are different. So it prints it is not palindrome. So this is how we find out the reversal of a number and also check if it is a palindrome or not. So this was for the number part. Now let's quickly move on to the code and see how a string can be checked for palindrome. For the string, the code is quite simple. Palindrome of string. Palindrome in strings. Suppose my name equal to input, enter a name. Now my reverse equal to name square brackets colon colon minus 1. If name equal to reverse, print palindrome. Else, print not palindrome. So this is the code for checking the reversal of a string. So initially my name will be having enter a name. So on the console, user gets this text format, text enter a name. And suppose user enters race car. So user enters the name as race car. So my reverse, what does reverse have? It is having name from beginning till end. Do the slicing in the reverse order. So this particular reverse will now have this particular R, A, C, E, C, A, R. So reverse will have race car and our name will also have race car. So this is the statement which checks for the reversal of a string. That is name, the input name, beginning till end, reverse the order. So now if my name is race car, equal to reverse. Reverse is also having race car. It will print palindrome. Else print not palindrome. Since here name is equal to reverse, it will print palindrome in this particular scenario. And One more thing. Suppose I make R as capital for the race car. If I make my R capital, so in when I reverse, it will have a capital R at the end. And Python will print not palindrome in this particular case because Python is case sensitive. Small r and capital R are treated as two different characters. So it prints not palindrome. Since Python is case sensitive, it considers R and big R as two different. It considers this R and this R as two different characters. So it prints the value not palindrome on the console. Even for Malayalam, if we take a capital M, so this capital M goes over here, this small m comes over here. So we have Malayalam in this way. So these two are two different characters. M and small m are two different characters. So it prints not palindrome on the console. Hope so, friends, it is clear for you how to find a reversal of a number and also how to check how a number can be a palindrome or not, and in strings how to check whether the entered string is palindrome or not. Hope so, friends, it is clear for you. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.